Hi, my name is Ben Hodes, Senior Program Manager for Project Siena, and today I wanted to walk through building one of our favorite apps, AdventureWorks. So let's take a look. The way this app works is you first select a video among many extreme sports that you're interested in. As a video plays, products that appear in the video show up alongside. And we have several different sports available. You can imagine that this app is in a very large sporting goods retailer on a large touchscreen display. So let's take a look at how to build it. I've already downloaded the AdventureWorks sample zip file here, and I've unzipped it. Let's take a look at what's inside. Everything that we need to build AdventureWorks. We have a README with instructions about how to install and use the app, the Excel file that's our data source, a Siena document, and the assets for our app. Now, a special note, Siena can only access specific places on your hard drive. That's in your music, pictures, and videos folders. We can also access the public users' music, pictures, and videos folders. Therefore, the first thing that we need to do is copy our assets, and we're going to paste them into the public pictures directory. And actually, that's all the prep work that's required. So let's go ahead and jump into Siena. The first thing I want to do is add my data from that Excel sheet. So to do that, I'm going to right-click or swipe from the top to view the top app bar, then click on File, Data Sources, and tap Excel. We can search for our file. For us, it's on the desktop. So I select it, click Open. Tap the tables I want to import, AW Videos and AW Products, and click Import Data. Now at this point, we can see that our poster URL images are showing up, which means that we've copied the folder into the public pictures directory correctly. Now, a special note, if you don't see the pictures at this point, don't panic. There could be a simple permissions issue with the public pictures directory. What you should do is copy the Siena assets folder to your user's pictures directory, go into the Excel sheet, and update all of the links. You can then refresh the Excel sheet, and you should be able to see the pictures. Everything for us is good to go. So let's take a look at our tables. Here we just have a poster URL and a URL to the video. And we have a table that has information about all of the products available in our data set. A special note, we also have a showtime column. This is how we can tell the video, tell the gallery that's going to contain our products, what products to show and when. Let's return to the canvas. Let's get building. First, I'm going to add a label. I'm going to call it AdventureWorks. Go down to Design, Size. Let's make it a little bigger. Make it light. And pick up a nice shade of blue. Next, I'm going to add a gallery to actually see my poster images so I can select a video. I'm going to go to the plus sign. Go to Galleries, and I'm going to select an image gallery with caption. Actually, this time I'm just going to select an image gallery, horizontal. I'm going to have it pick up the videos table, and since Siena automatically guessed that I wanted to see the pictures in my image gallery. Next, we're going to need our second screen. This second screen is where we're actually going to play the video. To add my second screen, right-click or swipe from the top. Click Add Screen. Tap on Screen 1 to return. Now, let's add a behavior that says when I tap on the image, navigate to the second screen. To do that, I'm going to select my image. I'm going to go to my behaviors. I'm going to go to On Select. Go to Navigate. And say Navigate to Screen 2. Let's click it. Works great. On this screen, let's add a visual. If you remember, we need to add a video player that was the full size of the screen. I'm going to go ahead and remove the default image. And then media is what the video is actually going to play. So let's go to media. And what we want it to do is play the selected item from screen one that we just clicked. So gallery one, bang, selected. And we want to pick up the video URL. So I clicked on rock climbing video. and I get the rock climbing video. I'm going to go ahead and add a back button now under shapes, back arrow, so that I can return to the first screen. I'll make it black, and I'll add an on select behavior to navigate to screen one. Next, I'm going to add the gallery so I can actually see my products. So I'm going to go to the plus sign, galleries, and this time I'm going to add a vertical image gallery with caption. I'm going to have it pick up my products, and now I'm seeing all of the products available. Let's move it over here. I'm going to resize this so I can see some more items. To do that, I go to design, template size. Let's remove the default and make it about 200. Let's make the template fill white. And then I can see that the image is getting clipped a little here. So select the image, go to image position. Let's change it to fit instead of fill. Resize a touch. And good, now I can see three full items. That's good. But I'm seeing all of the items. What I want to see is only items for this specific sport, for this video, and items that have already shown up in the video. So to do this, I'm going to use my Excel skills. I select the gallery, go over to Data, Items, and what I want to say here is I want to filter my AW products table and only show me products where the sport is equal to gallery 1, selected, sport, and only show me products where the showtime has already happened. Video player one, bang, time. Now, of course, we're very early in the video, so nothing's shown up, but if we skip ahead, we'll see the products are now showing up, which is fantastic. Finally, I'm gonna select the gallery again, go back to items, because we wanna add one more thing, which is a sort, so that the products that show up last end up at the top. So I'm going to do sort descending. Now, at this point, I think we've got a pretty good app. So let's test it out real quick. Let's hit back arrow. Let's watch the other video. Let's hit play. And as the video plays, products start showing up. Excellent. But you know what? I think we can make this app even better. For one, I want to see if I can... I really like that wetsuit, so, and I really like those shorts. I want a way to be able to save those for later. So to do that, let's go ahead and add a checkbox to our gallery. Go ahead and hit the plus sign once I have the template selected. By the way, you can tell a template is selected when other items in your gallery are grayed out. So we're adding to the template that's replicating across. I'll go ahead and add a checkbox. This will be our way to say save this item. And I'll remove the label because I don't really need it. Next, we actually have to tell the checkbox what to do. So we're going to go to behavior and say that when I check the checkbox, collect this item into a collection. And a collection you can think about is just a sample worksheet. It's just a temporary worksheet. If you're thinking about spreadsheets, it's a place where we can store information temporarily. Of course, on uncheck, I want to remove this item from the collection. Finally, we need somewhere to actually see our collected items. So I'm gonna just select a couple to preload the collection. We're gonna right click, and we're gonna add one more screen. I'm going to click Add a Visual, and I'm going to add a gallery. This time I'm going to add a horizontal image gallery with caption. Size it. Go to Items, Collection 1, and the gallery picks up our items. Awesome. One more thing, I need to add a back button so I can return to the previous screen. Go to On Select. Add a navigate behavior to screen 2. Now when I click that, I navigate to screen 2 and back to screen 1. Now this is even better but I can do one more thing to make this app truly shine. You'll notice that right now I have to actually hit pause on the video and play on the video. Let's have Siena do that for us automatically. To set this up, we're going to be using a little more advanced concept called a context variable. A context variable is a special value that we can pass from screen to screen. So in this case, I'm going to set mine up. I'm going to select the image. We're going to go to onSelect, and we're going to pass our context as a third optional parameter to the navigate function. We're going to say open curly brace, video paused is false. And one of the great things about collections is as you define them, as you use them, they actually become defined for you automatically. Now, screen 2 has access to the video paused variable. Let's go ahead and click that. On this screen, of course, we need to say that when I navigate back, I want to pause the video. So to do that, I'll need to first update the context and then navigate back to screen 1 when I click this button. To set that up, I'll select the button, or my back button, go to onSelect, and before my navigate function, I'll say update context video paused should be true. I put a semicolon in between expressions to chain them together, and now first I'll update my context and then I'll navigate back to screen 1. The final step for this app is we need to add a way to navigate to screen 3. So to do that, I'll go to the plus, I'll add a button, I'll call this view saved. I'll go to onSelect and add a navigate to screen 3. And then we'll also do the same update context video paused true. So that when we navigate to the next screen, the video also pauses. At this point, all that remains is to tell the video when to pause and unpause itself based on the context variable. To do that, we select the video, you go to data, select default paused, and then here we just give it the video paused property. At this point, I think we're good to go. Let's test our app out. Do that by swiping from the top and hitting preview. Let's see what we got here. I really like those skis. I like these poles. And all of my items are saved exactly as we'd expect. Hit escape to return to the canvas. And I'm happy. I like this app. I'm going to consider this done. So as a final step, what I'm going to do is publish my app. Publishing your Siena app will allow you to install it locally on your machine as any other Windows 8 app, or you can create an appex for sharing to anyone or anywhere in the world. So to do that, swipe from the top, or right-click, go to File, Publish. The first time you publish, you may see an update dialog. Perfectly fine. Click through and everything will be ready to go. I'm going to enter a display name here, which is Adventure Works Plus. And I'm going to say Publish Resources Locally. Now, what Publish Resources Locally does is it downloads and packages all of the assets, videos, pictures with the application, with my app, when I publish. This is important because if I'm working with local assets, like I am, it saves everything with the package so that everything is together. If I was working with a remote data source like SharePoint, what it would do is download all of the assets, pictures, and data from my SharePoint list, disconnect that so it would no longer be a live connection in my published app, and publishes everything locally. You could imagine that that would be useful in a situation where you might not have an internet connection or someone might not have access to your remote data source. So I went ahead and said, we're all local. Let's go ahead and publish resources locally. Click publish. I'm going to navigate to my desktop, hit choose this folder, and OK. What Siena is doing here is it's collecting everything together for a nice publish package for us. Let's go ahead and navigate to the desktop. And there's our publish package. Open up the folder and we see that we have a little install app executable. Double click that, and this is where we can see we can install the app on this PC, or we could create an appX for sharing. And this is just a standard Windows 8 appX. I'm going to just install it on this machine, so I click Next. And that's it. I'll return to the start screen. And in Windows 8.1, the app might not be pinned to the start screen, so I'm going to search for it by just typing. AdventureWorks, there's our AdventureWorks Plus. Let's give it a shot. And it seems like everything is working exactly as before, which is excellent. And that's all it takes. I hope you enjoyed building this app along with me. If you'd like to find even more tips, tricks, and information on Project Siena, please visit us online at aka.ms/Project Siena. Thank you very much.